It's week 8 of college football, and we give you 3 more of our best bets, and it all starts right now. Hey guys, it's Matt from GrandstandBettors.com. We have 3 more picks for you today for week 8 of college football. We will get to those picks momentarily, but if you are new to Grandstand Bettors, please make sure you go ahead and hit that subscribe button so you don't miss any of our college football picks each and every week for the rest of the season. And while you're at it, smash that like button. It has been 3 straight Saturdays of winning bets from us. 2-1, I think, 3 straight weeks in a row. Hey, but without further ado, let's dive in to week 8's top 3 picks. And for week number 8, we're going to be looking at Syracuse and Virginia Tech in this first matchup. It's at 12:30 p.m. Eastern. Virginia Tech favored by 3, and the over-under is set at 46. Now, Syracuse comes into this matchup 3-4. They've lost each of their last 3 games by a field goal, and each one of those were heartbreakers. If somehow things went differently for Syracuse, they may have actually been 5-2 on the season or even better. Now, what's even crazier is the last 4 games Syracuse has played, they've lost by 3 points exactly. So it's pretty fitting here that the line is at 3. Now, Syracuse's offense is a run-first offense, as they do lean on their 13th-ranked rushing offense, which rushes for over 200 yards per game, with Sean Tucker, who is about 70% of the offense that Syracuse leads out onto the field. This guy has had 948 yards, 9 touchdowns on the ground this year already, and he's eclipsed over 100 yards in 6 of 7 games that Syracuse has played in, including the last 5 games. He's also, get this, the leading receiver on the team. 14 receptions, 224 yards, and 2 touchdowns. Now, he is complemented very well in the rushing game by Syracuse QB Garrett Schrader. This guy has over 400 yards rushing as well and 9 more touchdowns. Combined, they average about 5.6 yards per carry. These two should have another great day rushing the ball against a Virginia Tech team that is 80th ranked in run defense and gives up over 150 yards per game. Now, over the last 4 games, they've actually given up over 180 yards. And last week against Pittsburgh, over 200 yards. If for some reason the running game is not working for Syracuse, it may be difficult for them to get anything going, as they are going against a very good pass defense, as Virginia Tech holds opponents to under 200 yards per game. However, these numbers can be a little deceiving because they have given up at least 2 passing TDs in 4 of 6 games this year. So we think Schrader will be able to find some holes in the defense, especially if they start off the running game and run the ball successfully, maybe using play action fake, get the vertical game going. Now, on the other side of the ball, Virginia Tech comes into this game 3-3, having lost 2 straight to top 25 teams with Notre Dame and Pitt last week. Now, we took Pitt last week -5 against them. It was an easy winner, 28-7 for the Panthers. Now, the Hokies have a very balanced attack behind Braxton Burmeister, who has thrown for 1,000 yards on the season, but only 6 touchdowns and 3 interceptions. He also leads the team rushing 212 yards, but that more has to do with the outside rushing that is against Virginia Tech and the lack of a pocket that he has. If anything else, Burmeister, he's already been sacked 14 times this year. That number may fly up this week as Syracuse is averaging almost 3 sacks per game. Now, his go-to receiver is Trey Turner, not the baseball player, but a junior out of Greensboro, North Carolina, and Robinson, who have combined for 640 receiving yards and 4 touchdowns. With Syracuse's run defense giving up 140 yards per game, Virginia Tech may lean on that rushing attack early with Blackshear, Holston, and Burmeister in order to free up that vertical passing game. But they do have, like we mentioned before, a great balanced attack. And given the Hokies a favorable matchup for Syracuse, they may be able to surprise that defense a little bit more than people would think. The Hokies, yes, they're going up against a Syracuse defense that is ranked 30th in the nation, giving up only 340 yards per game. But That defense tends to let their guard down on one side of the ball, at least per game. And yes, the Syracuse defense looked great last week against Clemson, but let's not overreact to that name of Clemson. Clemson's offense really struggling this year. They've only scored over 21 points once all season long. This Virginia Tech team is going to be able to put up points this week against the Syracuse defense. And likewise, the Hokies, in all honesty, they're going to be able to run the ball against the Syracuse defense, a rush defense that has almost allowed 400 yards rushing over the last two games. This one has all the makings of a very back and forth game. Whoever wins the turnover battle really is probably going to pull out the win. We think this game being played back and forth, we're probably going to look at the total here. So with our first pick for week number 8 in college football, we're going to take Syracuse, Virginia Tech over 46 points. Now, with our second pick, we're going to look at the matchup between the Oklahoma State Cowboys and the Iowa State Cyclones. Kickoff for this game, 3:30 Eastern time, with the line at 7 in favor of the Cyclones and the over-under set at 46.5. Oklahoma State's coming off an 8-point win over the Texas Longhorns. That puts them at 6-0 on the year. They are now bumped up 4 spots in the AP poll and rank 8th in the nation with this tough matchup coming up against them in Iowa State. Now, Oklahoma State's defense has been very good this year, holding their opponents to only 19.5 points per game, but their offense has not been exactly lights out, only averaging about 26.5 points per game. Junior quarterback Spencer Sanders has only thrown for 959 yards this season, but he does have the ability to make defenses pay with his legs, as he has rushed for 216 yards and 3 touchdowns. The only time Iowa State's defense has faced a dual threat quarterback this season was against Baylor. And in that game, their defense gave up almost 31 points, which is the most points they've given up in a game this year. And they ended up losing this game. We said almost scored 31 points. No, they did give up 31 points. As good as their Iowa State defense is, Oklahoma State has an offensive scheme to keep the Cyclones on their toes, should be able to move the ball down the field consistently to pull out a victory in this game. Now, the Cyclones are 4-2 on the year, suffering losses to Iowa and Baylor, as we just mentioned. Like the Cowboys, Iowa State's strength this season has been their defense. They rank 3rd overall in total yards, 4th in pass defense, and 14th in run defense. They also only give up 16 points per game, but as we mentioned, their kryptonite seems to be defending that mobile quarterback. Now, offensively, the Cyclones are led by their running back, Hall, who has been fantastic all season long, rushing for 748 yards, 10 touchdowns so far. And Oklahoma State is going to have their hands full with Hall. And if he gets hot in the first half, that could open up the game a little bit for Brock Purdy to try and pick apart a very solid Cowboys secondary. Senior Xavier Hutchinson has been the go-to target for Purdy, who has over 400 receiving yards, 3 touchdowns, but Oklahoma State definitely knows that. Purdy's most likely going to have to be forced to throw the ball to others, and that could be a problem for an offense, as their next two leading receivers are their tight end and their running back. This is most likely going to be a low-scoring game, given the defenses on both sides, with the 3rd and 18th ranked coming into this game. If that's the case, the game is probably going to be close and come down to maybe a fourth quarter play. Now that Oklahoma State is ranked 8th in the country, the college football playoffs have been on their mind if they finish out the season without a loss. Iowa State, definitely better than their record indicates, and playing at home makes this a tough game for the Cowboys to keep that season alive undefeated. The books definitely don't think Oklahoma State should be in the 8th ranked team, or it wouldn't be a whole touchdown spread, but we do expect a close game in this one. So with our second pick of week 8 in college football, we're going to take the Oklahoma State Cowboys plus 7 over Iowa State. Now with our final pick, we are going to look at the 3:30 Eastern time slot again. Matchup between visiting Clemson Tigers and the number 23rd ranked Pittsburgh Panthers. Pitt is favored by a field goal in this one, the over-under set at 48. After barely beating Syracuse last week, Clemson Tigers are now 4-2 on the season, and it is becoming increasingly apparent that without Trevor Lawrence and Travis Etienne, it might take a while for this team to make it back to that college football playoff. Now, Clemson's QB DJ has not lived up to any of the hype this season, only throwing 974 yards and 4 touchdowns. The way he stepped in for Lawrence last year kind of gave you that optimism coming into this year. It just has not panned out so far. They're only averaging Clemson 20 points per game this season. They have not been able to get the ball to their playmakers like wide receiver Justin Ross. Really, the only reason that these guys are not 1-5 on the season is because of their defense. They've only given up 12.5 points per game all year. Now, when teams get on their side of the field, they've done a very good job trading field goals for touchdowns on their defense, with the exception of Georgia, who honestly probably now could beat them by 20. This Pittsburgh offense is probably one of the best that Clemson will see all year long. They throw the ball a lot, and although the Tigers ranked 32nd in the nation in pass defense, that is mostly because they have been playing the likes of Syracuse, Boston College, South Carolina State. NC State's quarterback, Devin Leary, who's thrown for 400 yards less than Pittsburgh's quarterback, he threw 238 yards in their upset win over the Tigers. So it's going to be a field day for Pitt and their passing offense. This passing game that they have could be a huge problem for Clemson. And if the offense does not get things rolling in the game, they could easily be blown out in this one. Now, on the flip side, Pittsburgh comes into this matchup on a much different note than Clemson. They're on a 3-game winning streak, which they have won by an average of 40 points, and they're 5-1 on the year. Their offense has been electric this season, putting up 533 yards per game and about 48 points per game. This is mostly attributed to quarterback Kenny Pickett, who has thrown for almost 2,000 yards this year and at least one touchdown to 9 different receivers. So spreads the wealth there on offense. But as we mentioned in our last video, last week, teams tend to forget about the Panthers' running game because of how deadly their passing game is. The Panthers, they've rushed for 208 yards against Virginia Tech last week. It's a very diverse offense that should give Clemson a very hard time on Saturday. Now, although Clemson has had its offensive woes this season, Pittsburgh's defense, particularly their secondary, can give up a lot of yards. Against two of the better teams that the Panthers have faced this year in Western Michigan and Georgia Tech, they have given up 330 yards passing in both of those games. Clemson's passing game's definitely not what it used to be, but DJ can throw the ball, and he has the ability to also run the ball. As we mentioned earlier, Tigers mostly going to have to score points to stay in this game against a very, very good Panthers defense. Now, do we see Pitt laying up in this game? Probably not. The past two times they played Clemson, they have a 52-17 loss and a 42-10 loss. This is a perfect chance for the Panthers to get revenge against the Tigers, and they do have the offensive weapons to do that. So we see Pitt rolling offensively as Clemson tries to keep up in this game. So with our final pick for college football week number 8, we're actually going to take Clemson-Pittsburgh over 48 points. That's it for us here at Grandstand Bettors. Remember to join and take part in our college football leaderboard by putting your best bets in the comments below. Remember to read the pinned comment because it is important. It has the rules, and the rules are important. You must follow the rules. Also, join us on Patreon. We are now on Patreon. You can get a daily sports pick each day, $6.99, less than a quarter each day. I think we're 3-1 since we've started. So join Patreon. The link's below in the description. But as always, guys, sit back, relax, enjoy college football week number 8, and we'll see you next week.